Welcome to Sandy Beach Cottages, located in the Bonnechere Valley. Located 160 kilometers west of Ottawa, with the nearest city of Pembroke just 50 kilometers away to the north. This cozy resort has complete housekeeping cottages plus the lake house bunkie. Located on Lake Clear, this resort provides anglers with opportunities to catch multiple different species of fish, including northern pike, walleye, yellow perch, trout, large and smallmouth bass, whitefish, and ling. The bottom of the lake is soft at the west end with shallow weed growth. From the first island on eastward, the bottom becomes mostly rocky with small sandy pockets in some of the back bays. There are growths of aquatic grasses such as wild rice and sawgrass near the outlets of creeks and towards Little Lake Clear. Okay, we get it a first afternoon. Nice place, beautiful beach. They probably have the best beach on this whole lake. I mean it, man, it's like 300 plus feet. Walk up to here, it's still sand. But we go out and what am I gonna do? Try topwater, search and destroy it. Oh man, I'm gonna have some fun in the deep weeds. I love this lake and the deep weeds. Beautiful green weeds. What am I gonna use? Beaver bait. Look at how that thing fights. Look, I think it's a largemouth. It is too. Oh, nice largemouth too. Look at him. Hey. That's the kind of bucket mouse you catch right there, right? Look where he's got it too. Wasn't sure about the color. Color's the deal. Right through the schnoz. That's where you want them, right there. See that? This area, man, has so many different varieties of fish. That's not the biggest bass you're going to see, but when you catch them, like in this kind of clear water and those weeds, it's worth it, man. I'll just let them swim. Ready, buddy? Ready? Go on. Pitch, pitch. I'm making longer pitches than I normally do when I fish in deep weed. When I fish in deep weed, I like to fish them with vertical. But again, we first got here a couple hours ago, unpacked, you know, said hi to the lodge owners, the whole deal. And then came out, played around a little bit. So throwing the big baits. This beaver bait with the little kicking tails has a real subtle fall. So when I'm pitching it with the 3/8 ounce tungsten weight, goes inside that top of the weed and just falls through. So unintimidating. When fish see this, they eat this. From the pike, the largemouth, smallmouth, and the walleye. What do you hear? Oh, El Pico, look at that. Of course this area's got pike. Pike love this weeds too. Look at him. El Pico. Come here, El Pico. Chunky little northerns. Let him go. Go on, boy. And man, nothing better than just muscling fish out of weed. And how do you do that? I got the 7.4 St. Croix, 16 and 20 pound edge fluorocarbon, 3-odd, 4-odd, owner wide gap, beaver baits, and man, when that bait goes in and it's falling, repetition over and over and over, weed edges, outside, thick stuff, all of a sudden there's weight, or all of a sudden it just goes, boom. That is magic. See? Yeah, it's a nice walleye. Look. Look at that. Look at that. See? Look at it. That's a nice walleye right there. On that edge right there, dude. Oh yeah. What do you think of that? Oh yeah. Hey, Mr. Walleye, hold on. So I was talking about right there. Nice walleyes on the bass baits, eh? Beautiful. Love it. Look at that. That bass bait. Right on that 12, 13 foot edge. That's a beautiful walleye anywhere, man. But we're here to inspire you to think about this area here. Ready, walleye? Oh yeah. He's got attitude too. So there's lots of ways, you know, I can throw grubs and hair jigs and stuff too. But when you can manhandle these fish, smallmouth, largemouth, walleyes, with the heavy power, 16 pound fluorocarbon, and a bass beaver bait,
Is there a better way to catch fish? I don't know. And I said the witching hour is just about to start. So let's turn around a little bit, put this bait back on the weeds, catch some more. I love it in this place. Okay, next morning I go for some smallmouth and it's just not happening, man. You know, areas, long sandy points and stuff, you think it'll just be on fire right at sunrise, not. So as stubborn as I could have been, I stayed out there for a while, about an hour, moved all around, different baits, not happening. Picked up again, beaver bait, go back to the weeds and start catching some beautiful largemouth bass. It's good size, whatever it is. Ooh, I think it's a good largemouth. Look at it, oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Morning of largemouth, huh? Morning of largemouth. Right on. Take a picture and let them go. Okay, between the beaver bait and the split tail grub, rig Texas, I was able to catch some decent largemouth, some pike, some walleye, missed some smallmouth, but I'm having a great time. We're gonna enjoy ourselves at this great place, catch some fish, have some barbecues, and relax on the beach, and enjoy vacation, because I know you will when you come here too. Look at all those things fight. Look at that thing fight. Unreal, eh? Oh, look at the big pike behind him. Look at this. Oh, wow, you can see that clear as day. Big pike wanted to eat my bass. Good thing he didn't eat my bass, eh? He's fighting like crazy. Big pike came out of those weeds. He's like, what was that? You're lucky, bass. You're lucky. You almost got chewed. Almost. Go on. So I changed up to I'm seeing lots of little perch, okay? So I changed up to a little split-tail grub. Rigged the same way Texas, which it means like 3-odd, 4-odd, wide gap, tungsten weight. And just pegging the tip so I can fish right in these weeds. And now I'm getting way more bites. Seeing fish, missing fish, catching fish. Let's go. Largemouth. Little largemouth. Start our morning with a little largemouth. Smallmouth were not cooperating at all, dudes. But we like the largemouth, don't we? Small, but spunky. Go on. All right, once again, I see the perch everywhere. Perch everywhere. And every time I see those perch in those thicker clumps, I'm getting bit. So I picked up the split-tailed grub once again, fished that, picked up some good bass, and one real chunky largemouth that was sitting in the same weed. So when you're fishing lakes like this, you see the thick weed, look at the contour edges, see where it's dropping off into deeper water or the thicker weed, and sometimes those will hold the bigger and better fish. Northern. Albico, look at him. Look at that deadly bugger. Lucky where I got him, eh? On the side of the lip. Look at that. Didn't have to hurt him, eh? But when you catch pike, when you're catching bass and walleye, you saw where you got him on the edge of the nose, but sometimes they slash at the bait. So you check it all the way just to make sure. I'm gonna replace my bait. We're all good. So the northerns are adding some excitement between the walleyes and the largemouth. Let's keep going. See, first thing in the morning, perfect conditions, man. I mean, late summer, dead calm, the only one sunrise on that spot. But I was fishing too deep. You know, these smallmouth are eating these small of the perch, young of the perch. So I went to the deep weeds again, picked up the soft plastics, heavy casting gear, caught us some fish. But then I came back again, said, you know what? They gotta be some of those big smallmouth, have to be. First cast with the popper, get nice big thick bass, and he's got buddies all with him. Oh my God, two big smallmouth. Two. There was a giant beside him. A giant. Look at these fish pull, huh? It didn't take long to find these smallmouth, huh? He's got that underneath his jaw. You know why? Because he slashed at it. He had like a 4-pound friend beside him. His friend was about 4 pounds. Look how that thing pulls. Wow. And that's what they look like right there. Nice fat. Look at those bellies. Tell me these fish aren't eating, eh? Oh boy. Look how fat that is. Gorgeous weed-dwelling smallmouth. Let's let him go, okay? Ready? Go on. So moved around the lake a little bit. Came to an area with some weeds close to shore, but the key is deep water. It was 60 feet of water right there. So that proximity to the deep water or the safety, forage, whatever it is. Then they move into the weeds and feed. First cast, top water, gets it done. Let's get some more. Something about moving around and being versatile is the key on lakes you know and even lakes you don't know. I don't know how big he is. Oh, it's just a small one. But another big one behind him. Oh my God. There's so many bass around here right now. I got the little guy and there's about a 3.5-pounder was behind him. Unbelievable. But how can you beat that kind of fishing, man? Smallmouth are fun fishing. Smallmouth are fun fishing. Fun fishing. Fun, fun, fun. Shake them. Check your hooks. They're good. Let's keep fishing. Okay, I just went to the smaller popper, okay? Because I see these bass roaming all in between 4 to 6 to 8 feet of water. Sporadic, brittle weed, and they're just eating perch. You know, I thought maybe crayfish bite. It's not. It's perch bite. 4-pounder is going to eat it. They are, oh yeah. They are all along here, dude. Dark fish too. Pretty neat, man. And you can catch them like this. Look at the one beside him. Look. Look how big that one is behind him. Look. Look in the water, dude. Right there. Right there. Big black smallmouth. That's probably 4 or 5 pounds. The one beside him is about 4 or 5 pounds. You can see him all black. He's right underneath him. Oh my goodness. He's right there. Look. See that black thing right there? That's a big smallmouth. That'd be 4 or 5 pounder. And yet I get the 2-pounder. No complaints, but I want the big ones, dude. I want those big ones. Two big ones I need. Two big ones. I need two big ones. Just gonna shake them off like this. I ain't gonna touch him. There he goes. I'm not kidding you, man. There was a pure black giant 4 or 5 pounder with him. We just need one of those to eat it first. So I found the best way for clear water fishing like this. I wanna get that bait as far away from me as possible. So I throw it on a spinning rod with 15-pound gamma torque, little bait tied right to the line tie and just whip it out there. Because remember, the torque you use on the hook set is gonna be the same at the hook as it is at the power of the boat. There's no stretch and braid, hence cover lots of water, find those smallmouth, catch those smallmouth with a little popper.
At Sandy Beach Cottages, all cottages are equipped with full-size refrigerator, stove, microwave oven, coffee maker, toaster, as well as everything you need to prepare and serve a meal, and have propane wall furnaces installed in all cottages except the bunkie. Each cottage at this resort has full accesses to Wi-Fi. They have paddle boards, kayaks, and canoes are free to guests to use, and pontoon boat day cruise available with hourly rate with the skip Captain Miles. And for the families, they have one of the finest sandy shallow beaches on the entire lake.
See these fish roaming around like that? They're trained on that perch bite right now. You know, I threw Ned Rig, drop shot, stick worm, you name it, at those fish. They triggered, looked, and as soon as it went past them, they just swam off. They wanted that high bait the way they're eating right now, these perch. I know you say, well, there's always different ways to catch them. Yeah, there is, but the topwater, staying away from the boat, long casts, twitch, twitch, reaction bites. Sometimes take what Mother Nature gives you. You go for the reaction bite, if that's what you're getting, take it. Stay down. Stay down. That's the fish. Stay down. That's it, fish. Don't jump. I know you want to jump for TV, but don't do it. Here he comes up. No, he's not that big. I thought he was bigger than that. But he's a nice bass. Ooh, nice color. Nice looking fish. There he goes. Bye. I thought he was bigger. He's still enjoyable. It's almost lunchtime, then we're going in to eat. Wow, do you believe these fish? Unreal. But there's one common denominator too, okay? Edge, either the outside edge of the weeds, which is about 8 feet, or the inside at about 4 feet. Small perch, and there's always another fish when I hook a fish, always. So that tells me that they're traveling in packs. Sometimes I see three or four, but the trick is to just keep moving. You know, don't stay in one spot, keep moving. If you catch a few fish, okay. If you see fish boiling, okay. But mostly it's covering water, finding those roaming fish. Because when there's two or three, one's gonna take a chance. When your little popper lands, make the small little twitch and get ready. Might be a better fish. Feels like a better fish. I'm bringing him away from those weeds, but I can't rush him. Yeah, that's a better one. He's got a bigger one with him too. Look at that. He's got a big one with him. Can you believe that? I'm gonna have to, yikes. Okay. There he is. I gotta show you what a football looks like. Look at this. Tell me these things aren't feeding. Look at that. Look at that. His girth is almost like his length. That's unbelievable, man. I'm gonna put him in the live well for some pictures, then let him go, but tell me they're not in the feed bag in late August up here. Wow, look at that, psychotic. Put him in there, a little bit longer, and I'm done. See, when you're fishing like this, you make those long casts, it's paramount to put 100% concentration when it lands. Right away, engage, tighten up a bit, because these fish, they know right away when it lands. This water is crystal clear, like coming out of your tap. So as soon as that bait lands, whether it be 4 feet or 10 or 15 feet, they see it. So a few twitches, the bait sits, vertically like this, they're gonna eat it. Wow, it was just sitting there and he woke me up, boys and girls. Wow, he's not big. But man, does he get air, huh? So many smallmouth feeding. Oh, their bellies are all just psychotic. Might have to go up. I'm gonna have to. Oh, just one hook. Shake and ready. Here comes the shake. Bye. Whew, that's fun.
When you're planning your next Ontario outdoor vacation, consider Sandy Beach Cottages for both summer and winter angling adventures. Thanks for watching.